a weird angle on this piece. Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty, and it is Artcast number 81, and sorry, but this is gonna be a semi-short show because I am just running out of gas. I was just up late last night painting, and the night before, and I am just so tired. I just was really hoping I could get to the end of this piece right here. I'm not quite sure if I'm going to do it. But, I don't know. I just want to do a video today because I don't want to fall off the wagon here. And it would be easy to do that, I think. Especially as I get busy. I don't know. I didn't have much topic or anything like that, but there was just a couple things I wanted to say. I noticed a bunch of people, or not a bunch, but there's like four or five, maybe six people I noticed on in the Artcasters Facebook group, which if you don't know about, it's a group I made. And it's just for artists. Especially for artists on YouTube, and it's just a great group, and it's just awesome, and everybody should go join it. Anyway, I noticed there's some people selling prints now, and a couple people kind of messaged me, let me know about it. I'm not going to actually name anybody, because I just want to throw out a little bit of advice. Whether it's wanted or not, I don't know. But I could see that, like, prints are tough to sell. I just want to say that right off the bat. Originals are easier to sell any day of the week. I have a lot easier time selling originals than I do prints. And also, prints are really like, the way they work is they just hang around and then they sell when they sell. And that's pretty much what I wanted to just throw out there to, like, some of these younger guys selling prints, and hopefully not getting discouraged. But the reality is it's discouraging selling prints because it's freaking hard and it takes forever. And they may sell and they may not, you know what I mean? I wish I could sell 20 prints every time I do a piece. I probably wouldn't even sell original art, but I can't do that. And I have an audience, and you know what I mean, have built up people who bought stuff from me for years now. And when you're just coming straight on eBay and stuff, it's a game that you gotta, like, win by persistence, you know? You gotta hang in there and just keep listing and not caring when it doesn't work, you know. So there you go. Just want to throw that out there. Hopefully I didn't bum anybody out, but I don't know. It's not something, you know, I'm gonna, like, email or message people and tell them stuff like that, but you know, it's just something I noticed. A few people doing prints, and I just thought it'd be a good way to put that out there. Just like I always say, you know, I feel like I get people asking me questions and stuff, and all I can really do is just tell people the way I do it, and the way I do it isn't going to work for everybody. So when I tell them that and it doesn't work, you know, sometimes I feel like people get a little, well, no, they don't. They're all real nice, but it's just tough to do. It's just tough to sell art on the net, but it's not impossible. And if you stick in there and you keep going, you're going to do it. So that's my little pep talk for today. Now, I need to hear a pep talk like that, actually. I really do. But I don't know. I am super motivated, though. I actually painted this piece yesterday. Let's see if you guys can see it. Katniss piece, what is it, 8x12, I think, and kind of did it with the washes and color pencil. I like how it came out. And I got to show you guys too, like, I've been spraying them with a finish. I got the Clint Eastwood one out in the shed because it's kind of sneaky, but I really like how the finish is coming out on these pieces. And now I'm doing Gandalf here, and just cranking it up, trying to keep my head above water and all that good stuff. I don't know if everybody knows the story anymore, you know, it's kind of like so far back. You know, like people that came on later might not really know about me, but basically, like, when I started the Artcast, like, if you go back to number one, I was talking about quitting my job, or pretty much had quit, but I didn't really admit it to myself for a week, but yeah, that's the story behind all these Artcasts. Is I quit my job and decided I was going to either make it being an artist or not. I don't know, not really that. I just was going to make it as being an artist, and I just wasn't going to work for nobody anymore, and it's actually worked out pretty well. I've went well, I've been out of work for, you know, till 81 podcast or Artcast, and I don't do them 7 days a week. I do them 5 days a week, but so whatever that adds up to, 15 weeks or something, being jobless, and things are going okay. Things are tight still, but they're also like okay. You know. And speaking of that, I'm actually open to commissions too. I have a few commissions that I'm working on right now, but if anybody else wants some original art done, like a piece like this Gandalf, or anything else you want, you know, whatever your favorite movie is, I'd love to draw it for you. And this I could do, you know, for about $100-$150, so that's kind of the price of something like that, which is like a steal in my opinion. And also, I really appreciate everybody who's sharing my videos right now, because that's really helping me. Like, if you don't have time, you know, money to buy or whatever, and want to help me some other way, excuse me. The people that are sharing my videos around, they're just, they're helping me get out to, like, people outside of my own audience, you know. And that's awesome. Because that's kind of like what I sort of need, like, with my stuff right now. Because, like, right now I'm, like, running around like a crazy man trying to get outside of my, like, group that I've built. You know what I mean? Get this out to a wider audience so that my prices will go up and things like that. And when somebody shares my stuff, it just totally helps. It just makes that much easier for me, so I really appreciate that. And also, I've been trying to keep an eye on who shares my stuff and share their stuff back, but the thing is I miss it, because I might catch, you know, just the way, you know, Facebook works, it's like I might catch your post, I might not. I always, you know, if somebody wants me to share something specific of theirs, and you're helping me out by sharing my stuff, just message me and go, hey, you know, I shared your stuff, and I got this coming out, and I'll you know, reciprocate. What happened this weekend? We did that Google Hangout chat, and I was thinking about, like, some of the stuff towards the end. It's like everybody kind of cleared out. There was a bunch of people in the beginning, and it kind of just got down to me and Peter and Jeremy, Peter Palmiotti, Jeremy Burley, I think his name is, and we just kind of just went on talking, and it was really good. I don't know if you guys listened towards the end of it, but we kind of started talking business and stuff, and not business like here's what I'm doing business, but just sort of like, oh, just a lot of stuff, some stuff about Kickstarter and all kinds of things, and it was really good and got me inspired. One of the things that I was thinking about was we kind of were talking about, you know, I mean, how hard it is to sell comics, and if you could, like, somehow do a comic and also, you know, do prints and stuff like that to sell. Man, I'm just so out of it today. You know what? I think I'll talk about this stuff tomorrow and just kind of call it a day today, because I am just kind of dying here. And I think I definitely got a little bit of a show there, so I can just stick it in Sony and render it out and get it on the net and go take a nap. So anyway, I'll see you guys tomorrow, Wednesday, for, what is it, episode number 82. So that's really cool. Yeah. Anyway, see you guys.